Hey guys, it's your boy Clippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career mode. Where last time I left off, I picked up a win over her Wolves in the Capital Hunt Cup quarter final, and I also picked up a victory in the Premier League, continuing my dominance. I mean, what do you expect at this point? I don't really know. Unless you're new and I have absolutely no idea what's going on, in which case, hello. Anyway, so as you can see, I have a game against Hull. You're probably saying, what happened to the final Champions League game? I won 4-0. So, top the group. Got a nice reward. 18.5 million. Not that I'm strapped for cash at all. That is definitely something that probably won't happen in this career mode at all.
Like, Tyler here to describe it for you with my good friend
Alex. I'm good for
there, Martin. Walking into the ground today, I've just got that feeling.
I mean, I have over 100 million, and I spent
game today, Liverpool
over 80 million. I'd say it's actually over 90 in the summer. So, yeah, I'm good for money. When you consider I spent that much and didn't bring anything significant anyway.
It's always been a wonderful ground, Anfield, for
everyone small
to express themselves. Reflected how well they're doing with the home record so far in the league.
They've been terrific to watch, Martin, during this run. 7 wins in 7 games. They won a fantastic run.
I mean, you could say it was mostly paid for by the transfer of the Hood. Kawhi Bryan,
off we go.
Mario Götze, and
big reshuffle for
Sanchez. But is the goalkeeper
Alaba starts with Nathaniel Klein as the wide defenders. Renato Sanchez plays with
I did spend in a good bit.
Sadio Mane joins up top.
Probably overall did make a profit. Oh.
And in the shot code.
Oh, Sadio, how did you not score that?
Liverpool, for so long, their most successful club.
I was looking at the top goal scorer list just before I started this game. Diego Origi currently sits on 16 goals, with Sadio Mane on 9.
Marcel Sabitzer.
So, instantly, that's a 7 goal gap. Which probably should have been 6 there. But Mane's attempt was only good enough to hit the post. But yeah. Sadio Mane is definitely not having the same effect he had last season, to say the very least. But then again, you know, I mean, after 2 really good seasons, I mean, in the first season, he was very unlucky not to score 40 close goals games.
And it's a header. Diving to keep out the header.
Well, you'd fancy the lad to score from that distance. But
5?
Still had a lot to do, and he did it really well.
Looking to play his teammate.
But that, in the second season, he really turned the
save.
Home game.
Well, they've got
40
the
plus goals.
In the middle of the field.
Most dominant king in 2 seasons so far for Sadio Mane. So, I mean, if he is going to have an off-season, but still provide me with goals, I'm okay with that. I think after all his hard work, I think he's earned an quote-unquote off-season. I mean, if he's scoring goals, then it's not technically an off-season, if you ask me. Right now, I would be happy if anyone scored.
They're grateful for that. Shot on! He's blocked that.
Firmino!
On the front foot now.
Now for another
corner. Hoping for the goal that would put them in the lead.
Oh.
Sancho, the goalkeeper. Good technique. And shoots!
Alaba! Oh, what a goal that would have been, but it's off the bar. Mane. Coutinho! You son of a whore!
That's a corner now for Liverpool.
Matip Center isn't good enough, but I do get in our corner.
And there is some backup for him in this position. Tries to punch it away.
In. Matip again. Come on, win that, Renato. Yes. Coutinho. All this pressure. We're going to break the hold sooner or later.
Trejo.
Maybe later then.
Challenges for the ball.
Wait, here we go. Sadio Mane! Oh, you son of a whore, number six! Fuck you! Whoever holds number six is. Rotten hell! Rotten hell! I know that's his job as a defender, but fucking hell. Firmino! Davis. Davis, you can rotten hell, please.
Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free. Well, they're in a good position here. Gonna try his luck. And the goalkeeper.
Yeah, after all that, if I conceded, I would have absolutely. I would have broken everything. Everything. All the things I would have broken.
Comes in with a tackle. And there is the.
0-0 at halftime. Somehow. I don't know how, but somehow. Like. Just look at that and take it in. Somehow I'm not winning this game. Heaton is having the fucking performance of his life. And it is really good in real life, so that tells you a lot.
The second half here at Anfield.
Oh, guaranteed.
Good progress with this attack. And a try one now. And the goalkeeper got a touch to that. Fine save.
I think all Liverpool goalkeepers are contractually obligated.
A good position here.
Obligated to be terrible. Because Harris was really good, according to a lot of
teams. Haven't put the ball out. It is the referee.
Last season, I mean, he was void the second best keeper in the whole Bundesliga. I mean,
well, that's a shame.
He has to be good. I mean,
but the substitute.
Maybe it's just him adjusting to the Premier League. I don't know.
Front. They're desperate to try and change this game. It's been level and now they're pushing on looking for the goal that will take them in front.
Coutinho. Come on.
Past his man.
Make a run with me here for Sadio.
Well, good through ball.
Mane!
Yet another corner.
Oh my god.
Well, here we can see the corner count so
far. Getting to the hour mark.
Matip!
I will make a goddamn substitution if I have
to. Looks like one of those days where the keeper will not be beaten. He's filling
first legs might be exactly what I need.
That could be a goal kick.
I'll give him five more minutes.
EA Sports, don't forget.
Probably one more fucking attack.
League fixture for Liverpool. They'll be hosting Middlesbrough. Yeah, really looking forward to this one.
I think
we're
going to
see some good football.
Gives it to Coutinho! I did say I would give him 5 minutes. This is a corner, so there's still a chance. Coming back out. Coutinho. Oh.
Tackle here.
Five minutes are up. Time to make the substitutions. I'm going to bring on Daniel Sturridge. Origi is looking a bit tired. And I'm going to bring on Mario Götze instead of Emre Can. And I'm going to put balls to the wall and bring on and Emre Moore instead of Roberto Firmino.
Substitution for Liverpool.
Now, will this game follow the habit of players I'm about to sub off score a goal? Well, just before they go? Or will this be one of those the rare games where they don't?
Fair challenge, balls out for a throw though.
Because they are going off now.
What about Hull City's next game?
They're playing Derby County in their next match, and I think they're going to coast home. Good challenge here.
Hold on, Nicholas. Ah, come on, Daniel. This could be your best opportunity to get to show me why you should still be in the first team.
Livermore. Hernandez! Credit for taking the shot. But what a good
chance. I was pressing X to have freaking Matip header it back to freaking carries. But he just stood there.
Just over. He might be through.
Sayo Mane. Daniel Sturridge. Emre Moore! Oh, Robson, you fucking asshole! Mane. Let me switch player! About 2 hours too late, Heath.
Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped.
Got to deal with that, Nathaniel Clyne. Come on. Use all that pace. Peace. Great ball. Ball to Coutinho. Somebody get in the box. Foul!
Makes a challenge here.
Oh.
Absolutely imperative now that they get this corner right.
Daniel Klein.
As they build this.
Mario Götze! Oh, the deflection took it straight to Heaton! Oh, look at this bullshit. They're time wasting! Yes! Coutinho! More! No! Coutinho! Sayo Mane! Mane! Yes! Oh, you fucking beast! Get in!
Absolutely delighted. He has been a king of a keeper.
It took until the 90th fucking minute, but I got it.
Well, he looks disappointed with himself.
That goal's been coming for the whole match. Yes, Sadio.
Well, a very exciting climax to an exciting game. This could
get in.
Well, it could be at this stage of the match. There doesn't seem much of an opportunity to come back.
He probably had the best chance of the whole game up until the and when he hit the post really early in the match. But when it mattered the most, Sadio Mane does what he does best. He slotted it home. And he won me the game.
I think so. Yeah, they can take.
It wasn't even one of the substitutes. It was the two players I had on from the very beginning. Philippe Coutinho assisting, Sadio Mane he finishing. Hey, it's good to know you had it nice and easy. You Chelsea.
Hotspur 2. Chelsea.
You didn't come up against the mobile brick wall as Hull apparently.
Hull City 0. So what do those results mean to the league table?
Whew, unbelievable. With 45 points.
In second, Manchester City with 27 points. In third, West Bromwich Albion with 27 points. In fourth,
come on, can go up to E8 because then you'll be worth that
in
little
fifth,
bit more money.
Up the table are Tottenham Hotspur with 25 points. In sixth,
not that matters, but, you know, City just to have it. 24 holy shit!
In seventh, climbing the table are Chelsea with 23.
Yeah, are Arsenal going to get relegated? Is that going to happen? Because that would be really weird.
The table, Derby County with 6 points. And then reading up the table.
I know it's December, but they're getting awfully chummy with the bottom half of the table. I mean, this is like what Chelsea were doing last season. And flirting with a disaster. I mean, you could say Leicester are doing it this season, but, you know, everyone is saying Leicester are returning to the north. From being down there. Her Arsenal shouldn't be down there. Chelsea, he should never have been down at the end of the table, but they were. Or for a brief period, they were. And now Arsenal are down there. I mean, it'd be weird to see Arsenal relegated. Which is probably he echoed by any Arsenal fans who watch me, who are like, don't let that happen. You're probably saying to a game, obviously. You wouldn't be saying that to me, because I have no impact on that. I mean, like, the only impact I have is, like, playing the teams in around that area before the end of the season. But saying that, I still have to play Arsenal again. So, yeah, I don't know how much help I can be. Plus, I don't care. If Arsenal do get relegated, it'd be weird. But it wouldn't be the first time something weird like that has happened. I can't remember what game it was. I think it was FIFA 15? And Everton got relegated. I think it was FIFA 15. It might have been 14. I know. I remember. It is on YouTube somewhere. It's on one of my. But yeah, Everton got relegated in season in an older FIFA, and it really caught me by surprise. I mean, I saw that they were doing bad throughout the season. I just naturally assumed that they'll turn around. But no, I actually spent I think it was only one season they were gone for. They were pretty much back to the next season. But yeah, I did have a season without Derby.
Highest ground in the top level English football.
We'll keep going the way they are. Next season I will have to play Arsenal unless I come up against them in the cup. It'd be so weird.
Champions Cup position.
I can't remember.
But they've been good value so far.
The last time I didn't have to play Arsenal in a Liverpool career.
This is the Liverpool side. Lloris Carey.
It's never been the case.
Today, David Alaba starts with Nathaniel Klein as the wide defenders. Renato Sanchez plays with Emre Can in central midfield. In attack, Divock Origi starts. He's been in tremendous form
maybe
recently.
Maybe some of you who also play career mode have seen, like, weird.
I think that back four is really important for them. They've got
relegations.
But they've got a bit of protection, haven't they?
I can
they should have more than enough.
Yeah. Of all the big teams in the Premier League, the teams you'd naturally normally assume with the league, in all my Liverpool career, well, only two of them have ever gotten relegated.
Defenders a tight time lately.
Everton a few FIFAs ago, and when I was Ripley young. Manchester City, but that was way before their peak, back when, you know, they were still, you know, a mid-table team, back before they got all their money and then became a rich superpower in England. This was like 10 years ago tops. No question about it. This was really long time ago.
Good defending.
So, I mean, I don't know if you count it, but going by who is on
it's kind of
normally on top of the Premier League food chain nowadays.
Here's the shot.
Yeah, those are the two teams.
They go in front.
I don't think Arsenal want to join that.
Attack. However, the opposition sets up against them.
Although saying that,
power to break them down. It's really
only one team other than Liverpool,
again, it's really effective.
During my Liverpool career modes, has never been down at near them. Spurs. Like, the only time Spurs were ever have ever been near the bottom is at the really start of the career mode if I play them early.
So the first
if I beat them badly, then they're down there. But they always come away. They're never down. They're any other point. Never. Like, other teams have been down there. Or United have been down there in career modes before me. How Arsenal have been down that far or before, but they got out of it. So, Arsenal fans will be hoping that Arsenal repeat that. And Chelsea as well. But Spurs are the only team on top of the, like, one of the big dogs in the Premier League right now. Who in real life.
Rhodes.
Who have never been down there for, you know, a super long
time.
Like I said, max, they'd only be down there a few games. And,
you know,
that would only be if they haven't really came against me. I think that's only happened a handful of times. If I could remember correctly, I'd say I probably wouldn't even be able to come on both hands because there wasn't enough times.
Well, they passed their way up into a good.
I'd say at most it's happened.
Just lost the concentration.
Six times where, because some reason Spurs would normally be like. When I come up against Spurs, it's normally at a point where they have enough points that when I do beat them, it doesn't affect their, drastically affect their position. Or it's super well on to the season.
And
that it won't send them super far down the table. Like,
a little bit more comfortable good value.
Like I said, it's only happened like a handful. Five or six times through all FIFAs, as I'd say, when I had a game against Spurs so early that when I beat them, it's them down near the relegation.
Just widened the margin here to 2-0.
Had situations where you saw a team like that, like an Arsenal, like a City, and like a.
Well, they're in a good position here.
Any of those teams down there, the relegation zone, you're like, oh.
Great defending there, stopping that attack.
I mean,
home team have been unconquerable, home or away.
I've actually seen Manchester City relegated on numerous occasions. Like, you guys know what I always do. Who's that? Whenever I finish this secondary career mode, I always check to just see how Liverpool got on. Just, you know, out of curiosity, as a fan. And I always check who won the league.
He's kept it out.
For you would not believe, like. Up until a few FIFAs ago, you'd almost always see Man City getting relegated because before they got their super team, they were a mid-team table team that were generally terrible most of the time. Like,
he went in well.
You know,
good play. But
up until a few years ago, man, no one really paid too much attention to Man City. They were just the other team from Manchester.
Poor throw, straight to the opposition.
It shows that not only in real life has the money, he changed how Man City he play as a team. And as a club.
Well, a real treat in store for you.
It has changed
on EA Sports the, of the Premier League fixture.
Them so much, it's County. Affected its FIFA as well.
I think we're going to see some good football.
Like, the stat I get, here you go, I suppose for Ragged Liverpool crumb. The secondary crumb, well, I think I've seen a few
about one of the goals
who shocking relegation, but Manchester City happened the most, without a doubt. Like, the only other teams with, you know, few noble relegations are Arsenal and
Middlesbrough's next game, Alan.
Yeah, they're playing Spurs in the next match.
Really enough, Spurs.
And I think it will be difficult.
Because, again, these are, like, a few years ago, Spurs had pretty much nothing special about them.
Shut off now. Just needed to settle.
They were just another team in the Premier League. They were just the other team from North London who played Arsenal twice this season. Everyone's just like, oh. Arsenal
playing
their rivals, let's see how they get on.
Liverpool take over.
It was only when Spurs started getting into European football on a regular basis and start producing amazing players like they are now that people started paying attention to them other than, you know, their followers.
Looking at him, he got his move that he wanted really to, and he heads it for goal. Headed it well.
Because if, you know, back in the back a few years ago, as fans, we only really took note of who our main, who the main rivals for our teams were. Like, it used to be.
Into the attacking third.
He mostly Manchester United and Arsenal.
Eager to get in behind the opposition. Caught offside.
Defense squeezed. They knew they caught their man off.
From a Liverpool standpoint. And it would vary on each team. Like,
gets his foot in.
You would only really pay
Liverpool's
close attention to. You would have only played a close attention to Manchester City and Spurs back a few years ago if you were, one, a fan of Spurs, two, a fan of a team who were competing with Spurs for places, or had a game against them coming up, or three, if you were an Arsenal fan and you were just checking to see where they were, or you could side off any Spurs fan friends of yours.
Just over 15 minutes to go.
The Spurs, while they haven't, you know, they don't splash the cash like Manchester City, they've grown a team that has developed them into a team that last season was pretty much robbed of second place by Arsenal. And it looks like this season that they're definitely going to face
this attack very well.
I mean, like, unless Manchester United keep winning all around them, I can't see any reason why Spurs would drop that place. No, they just have to keep consistent and win the places theirs.
It's 82 minutes played now.
But, yeah. It's just, it says a lot about how the game has developed. And, well, some, a lot of crazy stuff has happened in football over the year. To the point where people consider, you know, the beautiful game is
with some
more corporate, and, you know, it's really the old style, the old football that we used to watch a few years ago is dead.
Regarding added time,
while it may be considered dead, you know, you can consider, no one's going to argue with you, that's your opinion. I mean, on one hand, you could definitely view who that era of the league to be dead, but, you know, in its place, a new version of the league has been is having its time in the spotlight. Now, whether you enjoy this kind of football or not is, you know, whether you enjoy a game where any player can be bought for pretty much any amount of money is, again, down to personal taste. But all in all, this you know, series of, as long as there's money in the game, there's always going to be big money transfers.
Middlesbrough 0. Let's see what that means for the league tables. At the top of the
something
table,
happens
Liverpool with
in the world that makes money completely second, pointless and worthless. That's the way it's going to be third, from United, now on.
28 points.
And
in fourth, you know, Manchester City.
Again,
28 points.
You can hate it if you want, but Chelsea, I don't think it's going anywhere.
In sixth, Tottenham Hotspur with.
So, you know. Well, you may not be a fan. It is a form of evolution for the game. And the people who don't like it, I mean, no one's forcing you to watch it. If it's really ruining your enjoyment of the game, nothing's stopping you from watching some else on a regular basis. I mean, you could still support your team, but, you know, just say, hey, I can't. And do a game where everyone pretty much has an invisible price tag over their head. I mean, again, it's down to personal choice. But I think I've gone on about this long enough. And I will end it there. In the next episode of Games Against Derby and Manchester City. And we will, as the season goes on, we will see if Arsenal can get themselves out of trouble. Or if the Gunners will be gunned down to the championship. Until next time, thanks for watching. I'm Joy. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.